Start. Yes.
Okay. So Babaji ji, this is the most frequent question. One of the another most frequent question asked to me, that what is one mantra we can do? Is mantra really works? And what kind of mantras, even if we don't know astrology, or even if we know very basic of astrology, what is one universal mantra we can do in our daily life to get a higher prosperity or wisdom, whatever you can call it? So yeah. I think you can answer this very well as compared to me. So please tell us.
Yeah, so when you talk of mantras, you have to understand the meaning of the word.
Yeah, mantra.
Yes. So hardly anybody knows the meaning of the word mantra. They think mantra is okay, some repeating some syllables, okay? Om or Bhur Bhuvaswa or whatever. Okay, mantra matlab achha, Gayatri mantra, Om Namah Shivaya, this mantra.
Yes.
What is the meaning of the word mantra?
Mantra.
If somebody knows the meaning of this word, this question which you are asking, now this will not come on you.
No.
The answer is in the meaning of this word. Okay. No. So the meaning of the word mantra is mana trai.
Mantra.
Trai means what? Trayate. Trayate mahato bhayat. Krishna says, you know, neha vikramana swasti pratyavayona vidyate. Svalpam apyasya dharmasya trayate mahato bhayat. Krishna says that anybody, even if they perform little spirituality, trayate mahato bhayat, it can give him freedom from the greatest of all fears. My God. Mahato bhayat means great bhaya. Bhaya means, you know, fear, great fear. Trayate, his all fears will go away. Okay. So now trai means to deliver. So then mantra means mana trai, means delivering the mind. But delivering the mind of what? Of all problems and anxieties.
Yeah.
Because when you will do consultations, you will see, I have seen in my experience, 90, I could bet on 100%, but let's say 99%. Okay. Let me give some room for some exceptional cases. 99.9% of the times, the problem is not the income of money. It is not. You may be surprised, you may be shocked, but it is not that money is not coming. You know what is the problem 99% of the times? Money is coming, but zero savings, all expenses.
Yes.
The more money is coming, the more the expenditure is happening. And then what happens? Because ultimately, see, nobody is rich and poor depending on the money. If your desires are less than your resources, then you are rich. Yes. And if your desires are more than your resources, then you are poor. This is an amazing definition of rich and poor. It is okay. When we categorize ourselves according to this definition, maybe we will never be poor one. Because most of the times, and I am very sure you know so many people, you know, within...
I know.
They have so much. They have so much that maybe any normal person in any world, they will never even have 1% of what they have now.
Yeah.
Yes. But still they are not happy. Why? Because desires are more than their resources. Okay. So that means mantras, where do they work? Is they work at the mental level. Okay, so when you say mantras work or not, well, if it is done properly, it will work at the mental level. Which means, suppose you are doing a mantra for Venus or Sun or Jupiter, any planet. What will happen is, it will not happen that suddenly all the problems of the horoscope, you know, not your problems, the horoscope problem. Because we are anyways perfect. The only problem
is in the horoscope.
We are perfect. We have no problems. You know, only problem is in the horoscope. And only problem is in the dasha. You see, sun is spoiled, so sun dasha is bad for you, right? So now, suppose you are doing some mantra for Surya, for Ram, you are doing, you know, Shri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Ram, for example. So it does not mean that suppose you have financial loss, it will vanish suddenly. It doesn't mean that. What it means is you will become more like Lord Ram if you do that mantra. And what Lord Ram was? He was Maryada Purushottam. He's the perfect follower of all principles. So then you will become like the sun, because the sun is always on time, you see. We'll never see the sun is late.
Yeah.
Okay. So as you beautifully said before, that if you are giving a word, always follow that.
Yeah.
So that you will also become like Lord Ram. Yes, you will also become like the Raghuvanshis. So then what will happen? Your mind will be peaceful, because you know there is no loan now. Yes, there was a very big person I know in a spiritual community. He's a multi-millionaire. But you know, till now, he doesn't have his own car or his own home. He doesn't have. Even now when he goes, he will go in an auto or a taxi. And this person has been in stock market and shares, you know. Can you believe it? He has been a very close friend of Dhirubhai Ambani. Yes. And when I called him, I asked him that, my dear sir. And his own father was multi-millionaire. And one day what happened, he was very much attached towards spirituality and gurus and sadhus and all this.
Right.
And one day his father became very angry. And his father said, "Bahut ho gaya abhi. Enough is enough. Stop going to all these holy places. Stop going to here, Vrindavan. Stop going to Haridwar. You should now take care of my business. Alright? And if you don't take care of my business and keep doing all this, then you will not get a penny from my property." And this was piling. And one final day, his father called him. He said, "Come here. Now you have to choose. You want my money or you want God? Choose."
Yeah.
Like Krishna also told, you know, "I will be on one side, Narayani Sena will be on the other side." So Arjuna, which one do you want? You want me or my army? Yes. Money is like God's resources. Okay. And then he said, "I don't want your money. I will continue my spiritual practices." And then his father told in Hindi, you know, that dialogue, "Darwaza khula hai." Imagine telling this to a 20-year-old boy, you know, in the youth, you know, "Get out of my house." You know, imagine telling like that. You know. And then he went out of his home. Whatever he had, his wallet and his clothes, nothing else he took from his home. The way he was, he walked out from his home. And now he did everything himself and he became so rich. And he told me that why he did not take a car, why he did not take a home. Because the moment you will take a car or you will take a home, what will happen? You will have loans,
desires, more desires.
Yes. For 18 years, you have to pay EMI. I mean, if you are a big businessman, that's different. But for a normal employee anywhere, you know, then you have to pay EMI, you have to pay loan. Yes. Then what will happen? Your mind is under anxiety. Or tomorrow they will fire me, then what I will do? Then I will be in the prison. And then what he did? No car, no home. Till now he stays in a rented place. Can you believe it? Till now. He's in Bombay and he's in a rented place even till date.
Wow.
And now the end result of all this is what? He is of the age 55 or 60 now. And now he has completely stopped all his material activities. You know? And he has handed all over to his son now. Okay. And then now he is going to different places. He is traveling and gaining spiritual knowledge and also preaching and spreading spiritual knowledge. Okay. And he is one of the most happiest persons I have seen. And hopefully this year when I go to India, I will also meet that great personality. Okay. In Bombay. So my point is, why was he able to do this? Why? Because he always used to be sheltered in God. Because he understood that this car and this home and I mean these things will not give you value ultimately. They are just like, you know, some dead bodies. You know, it's like hai to hai, nahi to kya farak padta hai. It's like that. So because he told me that, he literally chants mantras for around 2.5 hours every day. 2.5 hours every day, and he's doing this from last 30 years, 1987, 32 years.
Wow.
And his Guru Maharaj instructed him, because he asked his Guru that, I am going to Bombay Stock Exchange, you know, there is my job, and imagine that place, you know, money, stock exchange. How can I maintain my consciousness? And his Guru gave him a beautiful answer. He said, if you promise me that you will finish all the rounds of your mantras and only then step out of your home, then none of these will affect you. And that is what he did for 32 years of his life.
And so, he comes in the 1% exceptional case, which you were talking about.
0.00001. And then later on, of course, I mean, his father, he passed away, and his father was very rich, but there was some financial issues at the end, you know, when karma strikes, you know. Yeah. Millionaires, multi-millionaires, you know, they say now they come to the roads, you know.
And there is another, sorry to interrupt, book someone gave me, and I gave it to Dr. Aditya Togi as well. Om Swamiji is very famous in India right now, and he was a big shot millionaire, billionaire, whatever you can call it, and he left everything at a very young age, and he's doing a great service to the general public in India. I think he lives in the Himachal area. So this example of yours reminded me of him, because that exactly he did.
Yeah, because many times what happens is people think that, you know, money is bad or this is bad, that is bad. No, money is not bad. Money you can earn in millions and billions, like Yudhishthir Maharaj, you know, he did Rajasuya Yajna.
Yeah, yeah.
His kingdom was Indraprastha, I mean, before he became the emperor of Hastinapur. Yeah. Indraprastha was more opulent than Indra's city, Amravati. You know, the demigods, yeah. My God, what a miserable place this heaven is. You know, such a useless, worthless place this heaven is. Look at Indraprastha, my God. In fact, it is said, you know, when Krishna's assembly, you know, Dwarka, Sudharma, that hall, assembly hall, you know, if you enter Sudharma, where Krishna's hall is there, it is said, your body's aging stops.
Oh, really? Wow.
Yeah. Because your consciousness becomes so elevated spiritually, you directly behave at soul level. And at soul level, there is no aging, because soul is not body. Aging is of the body, right?
Right.
So if you stay 8 hours there, you know, it's like, you know, for 8 hours, you're not aging. So right. Somebody, the way they will live for, you know, 80, then they will directly live for 120 years. Because one third, aging has stopped.
Right.
Yes, so that is how his kingdom was. And you know, but the thing was, he used to use his wealth not for indulging in his own enjoyment. He used to do charity. He used to, you know, feed the brahmanas, the spiritual personalities. He used to feed the public. And then he used to utilize all his spiritual money for his all spiritual activities. And that is why he's known as Dharmaraj Yudhishthir.
Yeah. And people say the birth star, Dr. Sandeep Kanholiji and the Pai team, they did the analysis in one of their seminars, and they say the birth star, those who are interested to learn about nakshatra, they say the birth star for what I think the sun zodiac sign or the nakshatra for Yudhishthir ji was Bharani.
Yes, and his moon was in Jyeshtha.
This is Jyeshtha, yeah.
He was the eldest.
Yes, eldest, yes.
So, as you were telling me one day, you know, Jyeshtha Nakshatra has a lot of bad name in the astrology market.
Yeah. There are certain nakshatras.
Yeah, which have a bad name, as you told me in Berlin last year. Very, very true. That is, well, the problem is not in the nakshatra. The problem is in how we use those nakshatras. Okay.
Exactly. So, how we perceive it.
Yes. So the thing is, if we do mantras, and that is why I did not speak about mantras. I gave that person's example because then people can relate more, you know. Yes. How can a person who has so much, but he does not, you know, waste money on unnecessary things? And it's the same in my life when I see so many people around me. You know, for example, when I came to Germany for masters, now many of my friends who came with me or my acquaintances, they got very nice jobs here. Okay. So now start. So when they were students, very humble life, you know, no money, nothing to do. So okay, you know, just meeting the ends. Now you call them, my God. It's like suddenly you will feel they're from some different planet.
Yeah.
Oh, actually, you know, I have decided, you know, Audi, I will take this model, I will take. And then I'm like, okay, so what's the system? Okay, 300 euro per month you have to pay EMI, and then down payment is some 5,000 euros or something. So they will work for 2-3 months. So after 3 months, the amount which they earn is zero. Okay. And then for the next 10-12 years, you keep paying EMI. So then what will happen? Suppose tomorrow they fire you, then who will pay your EMI? No, right? Then you are in anxiety. Mana trai, yes, mantra. Then the mantra will not work, you see, because you are ruining your consciousness. Okay, now it does not mean that
one should not buy it, yes.
But my point is that when we are chanting the mantras, okay, then we will benefit at a spiritual, and it depends on our attitude also, okay.
Right.
So suppose we are doing a mantra by expecting that, or like many people ask me, you know, can you give me some Lakshmi mantra, secret Lakshmi mantra?
Right.
People think Lakshmi means money, wealth. Okay. Now, one of the significators of Lakshmi is it is wealth. It doesn't mean that Lakshmi is all about wealth.
Wealth.
Because Lakshmi Devi, she is eternally at Lord Narayan's feet. He is pressing the feet of Lord Narayan eternally. And that is why Lakshmi is known as Chanchala. Chanchal means today she is here, tomorrow she is in some other, in your neighbor's house, you know.
Right.
Today you buy a Mercedes, tomorrow he buys a Bentley. You know? So then you have this envy. Oh, uske paas kaise aa gaya, mere paas kaise nahi. Then you will say, this time I will take Rolls Royce. You know, I will prove my neighbor that, you know, I am better than you. But whenever Lakshmi goes to Lord Narayan, she is there at one place. So if somebody wants a lot of Lakshmi, you know, as finances or something, then they should always worship Lord Vishnu. And that's the biggest remedy, I would say. And the greatest blessing which Lakshmiji bestows is not financial abundance or prosperity. The greatest blessing which she bestows is your attraction towards Lord Narayan increases. That is the greatest blessing, because Lakshmiji is always there in the chest of Lord Vishnu. As you know, the symbol, Sri Vatsa, that symbol is there. Because when we chant the Vishnu Sahasranam, we say, Sri Vatsankam Kostubhod Bhasitangam, Kostubha Mani, Jewel, that is there. Sri Vatsankam Kostubhod Bhasitangam is, that is decorating his entire body. Okay. So Lakshmiji doesn't go anywhere. She eternally residing at the chest of Lord Vishnu. Okay. So when we are doing these the powerful remedies and mantras combined with study of the scriptures and lifestyle change. Okay.
Yes.
Because if you have a chair, you know, the chair, if one in Hindi they say, na, ek, what do they say? Paya, or what do they say? One leg of the chair is broken, then you can't sit in that chair.
Balance, right? Yes. Balance is very much needed. And I remember one of my teachers, he's in Delhi. I learned a lot from him, and I'm trying to bring him on YouTube, because he only gives the interview so far in Hindi. But he gave me a very good Babaji Ji tip, and I wanted to tell your audience as well. He said before, I wrote it down because it was a $1 million or $1 billion remedy, he told me. through you, through this message, I wanted to tell everyone. He said, before doing any remedies, he gave me the hierarchy. There is a hierarchy system, which you already mentioned very beautifully. And I wanted to make a separate video on this. He said, before doing any remedies, the first thing which you already mentioned is self-analyze your own character and self-realization. It is very must, which you already mentioned that. He said, once you have achieved that level, come down to the meditation part. It does not has to be 1 hour, 2 hour, 3 hours. Start with 10 minutes, but give you 100% to the 10 minutes. Or even if you want to start with 1 minute, start with 1 minute, but give your full intent. So that was the second hierarchy system he mentioned. Third one was mantra. So I find it very interesting. And I was like, is there a separate layer to this? He said, there is a huge hierarchy. He said, the fourth one is the dhyan siddhi. So first, self-realization, self-analysis. Second, the meditation. Third, the mantra. Fourth, the dhyan siddhi. If you have achieved the first four. After the first four, most important is, which you can match with the first one, is the behavior change, which you beautifully mentioned. Because not many people are aware of their own habits. They have more demands, less resources. Sixth one, he said, donation and charity. How many of us gives even a 1% or 2% or 5% of our earnings to the social welfare, which is again associated with Lashani? Seventh one, he said, just like lot of people are suffering with health problems. So take the help of naturopathy, go into the nature, go into the mother nature, try spending some time in the mother nature. How many of us do that? Mostly none of us. And then he said, after you do all this, if you wish, you can do the gemstones if you like. Again, he said, I'm not advertising the gemstone. He said, if you have passed the seven steps, then comes the gemstone, then comes the color therapy, and then comes the other hierarchy system. So I find it very beautiful. I wanted to do a separate video on that. But I think it was a very useful insight from him. And self-realization, I think, is the most important. Only after that, any remedy will work.
Yes, because the biggest problem today with these remedies is that, again, as I said, quick fix, shortcut. Yeah. So it's like when a person knows that, it's like one of my gurus used to say, it's like a paying bribe. Yes, it's a very strong word, but it is like that. It's like, okay, I have some issue inside me, which I don't know because I don't have any problems, right? Only my horoscope has problems. So then I have nothing to do with my horoscope, but somehow this dasa is not very good. Somehow this Shani is not good or Venus is not good. Somehow, even though I am the best person to we have ever lived, but somehow my Venus is not good, So that is why I need to do some remedies. And then the Pandit goes and he tells you, okay, go to a Lakshmi temple and that dhaga bandije jaake vaisa na, in that tree or something like this. I don't know, they do it for men or for ladies, but either ways, they say sometimes put it in your hand also, that is why sometimes you will see many people have this. And then suddenly you are again the best person in the universe, right? Because you have handled all issues of your horoscope, right? So now your horoscope is perfected. And you, what about you? You were anyways perfect. There was no problem with you. We were anyways the best people, right? So that is why when I talk to people at a personal level, when I do readings, I always ask the question, what kind of lifestyle do you have? What time do you sleep? What time do you get up? What do you eat? Yes. Do you have any addictions? What is your lifestyle? What kind of a person you are? What is, again, as I made the video today, 11th house? What is your association? That is like the ascendant in Kali Yuga. Kinke saath utte baithte hai aap?
very good video. For the audience who have not seen his 11th house video, you should go and watch it. Beautiful video he made.
Yes, and at the end, you are asking me that is there some mantra which somebody can chant?
Yes.
So now, disclaimer,